बिफोर महानिर्वाण भगवान सेज वेर कैन आई गो, वेर कैन आई गो, आई एम हियर, वेर कैन आई गो, आई एम हियर. इट इज नॉट एट द टाइम ऑफ महानिर्वाण अलोन, राइट फ्रॉम हिज 16th ईयर ऑफ एज. It is he who is established. All this cosmos is revolving around him. Where can he go? He is the self. Now, come back, come back. Let's come back. This is something I cannot define, but I can put before you. The hill is always there. It is only the Ramana body which has come to an end. The hill is still there. So what is the hill if not jnana tiralvuru? If it is not jnana tiralvuru, what is the hill doing when we are going around it, when we are climbing up to skandashramam? Is it not feeling Vasudeva Shastri holding a dead body? Who is Ramana, who is Arunachala? Is it not a laboratory experiment? Explain to us directly. Arunachala and Ramana, as Venkatesh ji pointed out, are one and one and one and one and one. So the Ramana Nama and Arunachala Nama, which Bhagavan himself says, Malayalit Arunachala Ramana en Malay Anindarul, Arunachala Ramana, there he says, Arunachala Ramana, because language allows only that much oneness. It is a limitation, but that's all one can point. They are one and the same. So the second magic that's available to us from Arunachala is the Arunachala Nama, is the Ramana Nama, Arunachala Ramana Nama. Whichever way you want to call, Ganeshananda writes in Moments Remembered, Bhagavan would never call himself anything, would never write anything in papers unnecessarily. But whenever a new pen was presented to him, or when some pencil was brought, was sharpened, or somebody wanted something to be written, he would write only one word. Not Ramana. He would write Arunachala. What is his name? We don't know. We don't need to know. If any of these three have come to us, that is the form that is going to save us. Arunachala Ramana, Arunachala Ramana. The person to whom this Nama has come is saved. The other devotees need not worry about that person. Hare re enna agumo. If somebody has received Ramana Nama, the other devotees are not to bother anymore. No, no. That is foolishness. It is tomfoolery. It is waste of time. They have to just do their sadhana, that's all. They have to just hold the feet of Bhagavan, hold the Ramana Nama. That is the Nama magic. Then the third magic that we have is the Giri Pradakshina. Now, Giri Pradakshina, Muruganar Swami will ask Bhagavan, what will I get if I do Giri Pradakshina? Bhagavan says, how can I tell? You go and do and see. And Muruganar, who has come seeking Mukti, he says, I lost the I am the body consciousness during Girivalam. I don't remember which part of the Girivalam. I think that's not important, is it? The Giri can verily give Mukti. The Giri Pradakshina, I had gone to Tiruvannamalai only to practice Atma Vicharam, because I had gone after a period of 3 years of observing meditation, observing the mind, and task was not complete. I don't know, in one of my trips from Chennai to Tiruvannamalai, one of the when I was returning to my home in Tiruvannamalai. It was late in the evening and everybody was doing Pournami Pradakshinam. So I simply joined. I don't know how many times he has blessed me. It doesn't matter, does it? One time is enough. One Giri Pradakshana is enough. The Jnana Pungava, Bhagavan, he himself has done Giri Pradakshana for 20 years or more. There is another example of Jnani doing Giri Pradakshana. Of course, there is the legend of Parvati Amma. There is the legend of Brahma doing Giri Pradakshana and getting rid of his papa. But we have Thidnai Swamigal, an engineer by profession, I think, to whom Bhagavan gave mukti with one word. He simply said, Iru. Muruganar Swamigal says, Shanmuga, Kartikeya, Muruga. He used two words to give mukti to Arunagirinadar. Summa iru sollara. He used too many words, he says. To Thirunai Swamigal, Bhagavan uses only one word, iru. Of course, even that is too much actually, because we don't know how many countless numbers the Arunagiri and Bhagavan have blessed with mauna, with no words, completely erasing all the karmas of the devotee just by the Shrestha Upadesha of mauna. But here we have Thirunai Swamigal. Why I took his life is that he continues to be in Tiruvannamalai. This must have happened in the 40s. The Mukti Upadesha and the Thirunai Swamigal remaining in that place. He has not moved from that Thirunai. You can still see his samadhi near Saduvam Swami Samadhi. It is next to that. Such a one who has not moved from the Thirunai, he has done one sadhana. He is a Paramajnani, he has done one sadhana. He has done Girivalam. He has done Giri Pradakshina. Why does a Jnani do a sadhana? If not to show to the others that this is the direct path to mukti. The way I feel it is that their own state is least disturbed by that sadhana. Their own state is least disturbed. That they recommend to us. Take this. Do this. Come to the same state. Come to this bliss through this sadhana. And what more easier sadhana can be there than Giri Pradakshinam? Just go around the hill. There has been, we will take our return journey from Giri Pradakshinam to Nama and to the Atman. This is hearsay. You can take it as legend, but I believe in this totally. There has been a devotee, I have heard this story narrated by another serious devotee. One Raju Garu, who comes and settles down in Tiruvannamalai. Those days, Ramanashram, it appears, used to give accommodation to stay permanently. Under certain conditions, it was possible at that time. The number of people were only so many, it appears. So this husband and wife team, they take off from Andhra and come down and settle down in the ashram. Raju Garu has only one sadhana. Morning, 3 o'clock, goes for Giri Pradakshina. Afternoon, he does Giri Pradakshina. Every day, two giri pradakshinas. Later on, he does only one giri pradakshina and he takes up the cleaning of the meditation hall at 3 o'clock. Finally, his body is so debilitated that he is not able to do giri pradakshina anymore. Then he blesses us with one of the greatest gifts a devotee can bless. He does mano giri pradakshina. From the rupam takes us to namam. How does he do mano giri pradakshina? Slowly remember each of the different places he has worshipped Arunachala on his pilgrimage in that 14 kilometers. Slowly. Last year, in November, our daughter got married and she had to leave for US, and we as a family, we have been allowed by Bhagwan to do giri pradakshina together. Once this happened, my better half, my wife, felt, no, how is she going to do giri pradakshina? So she was worried, my daughter is not going to have the opportunity to do giri pradakshina. This mother's mind is something Bhagwan uses again and again. In Aksharamana Mala, he says that the Lord's love is greater than mother's love. In very early days, I used to feel, why mother's love is being put down? But then I realized that is the nearest that any love can come to Lord's love in this whole wide cosmos. The mother's love is the nearest some poet can take. Arre, this is how, irrespective of how the child is, irrespective of what his nature is, irrespective of who he is, irrespective of whether he is having any kind of disease, irrespective of he has fallen in the gutter, the mother comes and embraces you. The mother's love is like that. It's so wide that you simply lose yourself in that, the vastness. Bhagwan's love is greater. She was really worried. How is my daughter going to get the blessing? Then she did. I had shared with her Rajugaru's story. So she started doing Manogirivalam at home. She started doing, along with the Parayana, she would do Manogirivalam. She would say, this is the spot. This is. No. Then she started getting that inspiration, that beautiful inner spirit that comes when you complete Manogirivalam. Then on Skype, she shared with Archana. See, though you are in Seattle, don't say you are not doing giri pradakshina. You do this, you remember those points which you have registered in your mind. Like we used to say, where the Bangalore road meets the Tirunamalai road, the Arunachala gives Ardhanarishwara darshana. Where the two, there is a ridge, the same hill, it is the same hill, it is one hill. There is a ridge which becomes clear when you go that side. But at this point, this ridge makes it appear as man and woman. The beauty of it, see, the man and woman is a mere outer thing. And inside, it is all pure consciousness. It's practically demonstrated by Arunachala. There, you can see. So, we remember that. A little bit down the road, we can see Arunachala in different light, in different light. In this, they are experts, I am not. They used to tell me, from here, he looks like Ganapati. I will take 3-4 giri pradakshinas to realize, yes, that's possible. But she has learned this girivalam in manas. Slowly, from giri pradakshina is not there alone. Even those who have done one giri pradakshina can do giri pradakshina in Bangalore. Don't miss this opportunity. Remember those spots. This will make you go there again. That's a different story. We'll take that up another time. But what does giri pradakshina do? There is a gentleman called Jairam sir. He comes for our satsang in Ramana Maharshi Center for Learning, South Bangalore Center in Padmanabhanagar, where Saturdays we meet. About 4 years back, we share these experiences in Giripradakshina. He opened, he has this knee problem, arthritis. He can't climb the stairs to come to the meditation hall. With great difficulty he comes. Once he opened, Nandakumar sir, once, Urvati, he is a Telugu, Urvati Giripradakshina pannita podum. Na enakku 66 vayasu aarudhu, I am 65, 66. If I do, before dying, one Giripradakshina if he allows, I am more than satisfied. He went the next Purnami. This is 4 years back. From that he has not missed a single Purnami. He has not missed a single Purnami. He says, now Bhagavan is giving me bonus. Because Shivaratri is also there. Every year not 12 Giripradakshinas, 13. He has been taught Giripradakshina to go alone. He has learned different skills. Arunachala directly teaches. All you have to do is do Giripradakshina, that's all. Just like self-enquiry, in self-enquiry there is no other niyama. Self-enquiry does not need any other niyama, because that niyama can come in the way. It is another thought which you will have to forcibly hold. But a self-enquiry is what? Going free of all thoughts, isn't it? Similarly, in Giripradakshina also, you don't need any niyama other than what Bhagavan tells. We'll come to that. That is also a blessing of Giri, to listen to Bhagavan's niyamas. But he has taught this gentleman some niyamas, he doesn't take food. He says it's like floating in air if you don't take food. He has his own methods. He goes very slowly. We have shared the story of how one should walk like a queen in her 9th month of pregnancy. Very slowly he walks. From his 7th or 8th Giripradakshina, what Bhagavan has done, somebody or the other will ask him. He used to initially say, Nandakumar sir, you are romba thondarav kuduttaanga enna free ah girivala panna vidala idu ennadu adu ennadu appdin kekkranga. Now he willingly tells somebody in difficulty. He used to say, those people had come, the family from Bangalore, they were saying, terrible distress we are in. I could share with the Girivalam experiences. Now, this is what Bhagavan does. He first enters your life, as Venkateji says, like the termite that eats from within. He completely makes you incapable of anything, as he says. But the beauty is, that is when he starts doing everything through you. Then you are actually capable of everything. Like the one who is incapable of remembering anything, I don't know how. I really don't know how. But then through this Jairamji's life, I can see that then Bhagavan makes him, when he says, I am useless. That's when we are, I don't know how. That's when Bhagavan makes use of us. I don't know how this happens. That is the magic of the mountain. That's the magic of the hill. That's the magic of Giripradakshina. From Giripradakshina, we have discussed Upadesha Saram during Giripradakshina. There is another family with which I go, and there are two children. Their children means they are quite youngsters now. Upadesha Saram we discussed. The connections Bhagavan gives during Giripradakshina, I have not read it in books. What we have shared, I have not read it in books on Upadesha Saram. He simply enlightens you from within. It's something happens which is not part of you, which is not yours. It is not yours. It is so clearly that your doership is erased. He will show that this is not yours. See, where was this? Is there any possibility? The incident in Bhagavan's Giripradakshinas that we can recollect for this is, Ramnath Brahmachari. Ramnath Brahmachari is a Sanskrit school followed. He comes and joins Bhagwan because he has this great blessing which the intellect can never have, the belief that Bhagwan is Bhagwan. Actually, that is the greatest intelligence. To me, Kau Lakshmi is the most intelligent being that has ever lived. Of course, other than Bhagwan, we can't call Bhagwan a limited being, isn't it? Because Lakshmi has recognized Bhagwan is Bhagwan, finished. That's all we have to do. Bhagwan says, it just left the kids there and said, take care of me. Why do we need an intellect? To surrender, no. That's what the Giri does, that it completely does everything for you. It makes you completely useless, totally useless. It makes you absolutely useless and totally useful. That is the time you are useful to your team. When you are totally useless, when you are absolutely useless, when you are incapable of anything, that is when you radiate some peace to your team. That is when you are of any use to those around you. Till then you are actually, till the time Bhagwan erases everything from you, you need the team for something or the other. See, in science it's called as entropy. It's called as entropy. Entropy means any closed system is supposed to lose energy. Like this whole universe, if it's a closed system, it keeps on losing energy till it collapses. You see that process, isn't it? Something close that's created, it has a cycle and it ends. When Bhagwan removes everything from you, that is when you breathe pure energy into the entropic system. The Jnana Pungava is the only source of pure energy to this entropic universe. Bhagwan Ramana is the only source. That's why we still go to the Samadhi Shrine. That's why Muruganar Swamigal tells Ganeshananda, where do you think Bhagwan has gone? Bhagwan is there. It is the same pure energy that is available as Arunachala Ramana, the magical self within each one of us. Ennayan Arivura Ennuru Veredu, Bhagwan says in that line. When I inquire, who am I? And know myself. Drishyavaritam chittam atmanah. When the consciousness, which has been continuously occupied with the objects, turns back, withdraws itself from the objects, and inquires, who am I? For the first time, it has chitva darshanam. It has self-knowledge. That is tattva darshanam. Bhagavan says, how come the self knowing itself, how come the consciousness knowing itself is the truth? Bhagavan gives very simple explanation in the talks. To know anything, you have to be there. Akka has shown this beautifully in a ballet, that even to see darkness, you have to be there. Even to see a blank, you have to be there.